name is Notepad, and on and I write games for fun. So what are we doing today? Well, today we're going to be working on Zombie Dark 30, a game about action horror zombies. Last time we kind of handled a lot of the basics of the gameplay. So I'm hoping everything kind of works out there. And today what we have to do is make operators. What I did in between was I kind of wrote the lore, which is really, 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 really budget. Umbrella made something called Lazarium. And now there's technically four forces you can join. You can join the Northern Light Security Forces, which is pretty much just Umbrella Corps Security Services. The Southern Expeditionary Force, which is like evil, like double evil Umbrella. The Stars, because I'm one of the special tactics called Assault Recon Services, and the White River Technicals. The Red Eyes, just mysterious mercenary people who do mysterious shit. Is it Gear Autism Day? Oh no, we are not close to Gear Autism Day. We need to get characters up and running. And though Gear Autism will, let's just say, Gear Autism will be coming soon. Like, just do not doubt that. There we go. Yeah, we're not dealing with Gear Autism yet. Don't. Sorry about that. Anyone who is excited about the gear. We need to do this. We need to put you over here. So dog tags, dog tags and black sites. Okay, so operators are individuals chosen for exceptional talents and abilities. Exceptional talents and abilities. These men and women are deployed into the field. With one objective and a stoppable drive to complete it. Each operator brings something different to the squad. Working together being essential. Yes, working together being essential to. Each operator brings something different to the squad. Working together being a key part in the assembly of operator teams. Some are actually the assembly of these teams, depending on the force they are aligned with, the background to each operator may be different. Drawn from elite military service. Military service, private military corporations. Security specialists, or even specially trained scientists. There we go. So what we need to do is operators chosen them. Private military corporation, security specialist, and even specially trained scientist. As for background information, nothing matters. to everyone on your squad, you simply have a call sign. This is a major part. This defines both your role and personality. Your personality in the field. In the field, far more than any name could. Forces under. Hello, phone. Who's pinging me? It's the Nosgoth guys. Thank you very much, Nosgoth guys. Remember Nosgoth? I remember Nosgoth. Me and my friends played a lot of Nosgoth. I had fun with it. Let's see. Not far more important any name could. Groups such as the Red Eyes. Actually, groups such as the Southern Expeditionary. Groups such as the Southern Expeditionary and White River. And White River Technicals actively encourage. Let's see, dehumanizing oneself with facial coverings and revealing little personal information. There's a job to be done, and it's up to them to do it. There we go. I wanted to add a little section on background information just for the very specific purpose of, like, you don't want to be known as, like, you're not going to be playing, like, I'm going to play, my character's name is John Gunman. No, it's like you're going to be like Mad Dog. Like, what do you go by, Mad Dog? Or like, what's your, you know, it's, you know, Clear Shot. Like, or it's like, oh, what's your name, Riverwind? This shit like that. Like, it's one of those things, like, I want to have like a very dehumanizing look to all the characters. Which seems a little bit odd, but it's like, yeah, you know, you're not really with one another on that front. Like, you have background information, but it doesn't really matter. Who you are is a secondary thing to what you're doing. Hey, how are things going? Pretty all right. We just started, pretty much. I'm just getting all this set up, and next we need to do, if I open up this is where things start getting a little bit wonky. I'm ready. Let's do it. Okay, so first we're going to start with... Okay, no, I don't need to sneeze. Again, I was like, am I sneezing? I'm feeling like I'm sneezing. Like, oh no. Okay, so what we need to do for characters, we need to talk about attributes, then we need to talk about skills, then we need to talk about... I wrote this out. Skills, combat capability. Then we talk about the vitals. Okay, so we need to talk about attributes first. I guess attributes would be like... That's the best way I can kind of think about them. I can't really think of like a funny, exciting name for them. Another Doom member of Alpha Team. Kind of things like that. It's like... Like, yeah, clearly you matter, and, like, you can explore your backstory if you want, but it's kind of more along the lines of, like, to a lot of people, you're just another expendable, you know, person. Like, you are an individual in there, you go in, you go out, you don't think about what you saw. Like... Because it helps you not think about it too much. But that's kind of the issue, is like, as things start slowly, you know, going wrong, you become more human, ironically enough. Which is the idea of being like, you start panicking, you start getting, you know, scared, things start going wrong, and you start, you know, it's, your heart starts beating, and you start getting worried, and oh my god, I'm bleeding to death! Like, that's what I kind of want the feeling happen. Yeah, you're a Delta Green member, you have a life, but you're here to do a job kind of thing. Like, yeah. That being kind of like one of the major kind of... Like, some of them obviously want you to be like, yeah, you're a real person, but like, not really. Like, don't think about it too hard. Let's see. We want to do, so attributes. Each operator has a series of attributes which define how they operate in the field. Because I went down like this, rough approximation of ability. Actually, series of attributes which are a rough approximation of their abilities and skills in the field. These are not definitive. These are not definitive aspects of the character. Definitive aspects of the operator. Simply a recorded series of notes. Yeah, actually, no, how do I want to do that? Approximation of their abilities in the field as well as their potentials. Operators with operators will assign, let's see, we have five attributes. What we can do, like a 5-4, like 5-4-3-2-1 kind of thing, being like one thing is clearly going to be weak, or we assign just gradual points to everything. Because let's say like an average person is going to be like 3. Like, let's say the average person is like 2 to 3. Like, this is the average person. So if we want to make everybody average, we would need 10, we'll say about 12 points overall. 12 points. However, these guys are a little bit more grander than that. They're a little bit more impactful. Things are a little bit more interesting about them. We can probably bring it up to like 15 to 16. Yeah, let's see. While the average human ability evens out around two to three in each attribute, operators are exceptional individuals. At the start of deployment, each operator receives 15. Actually, it distributes 15 attribute. Again, it's a little bit odd to say, but like attribute points, but that's like the best way to kind of word it. I mean, if I really want to do something weird with it, because what do attributes do? Attributes are derivative. That's the big idea. They're derivative. And I'm going to kind of tie them to skills, being like whatever your attribute is times 2 kind of equals your, maybe like your max skill in a situation. It also kind of like dictates other little aspects about you. Or we just say fuck it. Evening. How you doing, Eddie? Let's think. Operator is a series of attributes, rough approximation of their abilities in the field as well as the potentials. Actually, operators by their nature are exceptional individuals. Both in what they excel at and what they lack in. Each operator assigns a grade of A, B, C, D, E, actually A, B, C, D, or F to each of their attributes. The approximation of their growth potential, this grade dictates the approximation of their growth potential and current situation. Define and current abilities. There we go. Growth potential and current ability. So you're going to end up with something like resilience A tier, intelligence B, motorics D, psych F, and physique C. There we go. Not necessarily that it's like any better or any worse. It's just like that's kind of like you've kind of plateaued in that regard. You're not getting any better, nor are you getting any worse. Grade, description, let's see. Oh, no. A, B. Actually, what we should do is S, A, B, C, D, F. The agent is... Let's see. The agent is at peak performance. Let's see. Is at peak performance and can easily... And is the best of the best. The agent has peak performance and is best of the best. Best of the best in their field. A, the agent is noted to be in the upper echelons of that particular attribute. And let's see. B, the agent is above average regarding their current attribute rank. Regarding the attribute. Let's see, the agent is considered standard in the attribute if slightly above normal. And standard. The agent is perfect if slightly above normal. The agent is perfectly normal of a regular individual with this attribute. The agent is shown to be lacking regarding this attribute being below average. So we do the attribute grades, we do this, we bump you up a little bit just so people can kind of understand where you are. Actually, let's see, this grade, this signs a grade of A, B, C, D, E, or F. This grade dictates the approximation of their growth potential and current ability. Each operator, yeah. of their current ability. So these are your kind of your basic attributes. Operator. What'd you call a player? Oh, ranks. Yeah, S and SS. SS rank, don't worry. Yeah, they're. I'm referring to them as operators. Like, that's what they are. Operators. It's a little bit odd. However, it should be a good kind of understanding of, like, yeah, these guys are, to quote, operator as fuck when they want to be. But that's kind of the appeal of this entire thing. Is that they are, you know, these people are a little bit above normal. Let's see. Each of their dictates approximation of the growth potential and current ability. So yeah, you get one of pretty much all of these in everything. Guess actually what I can do is I can put this on here. No. Here's what I can do. We do attributes and then we immediately go into. There are a total of five attributes. In Zombie Dark 30. Each of them playing an important role in the operation in one way or another. Operators are encouraged to work together. Work together to make up one another's flaws. Actually, no. Or roll one or the other. And do we want to put this in a table? Half of me is saying put it in a table. The other half of me is saying. What I can do. Resilience, intelligence. And the last one, psych. Yes. E-S-Y-C-H-E. Psycho killer. So we do this. We have to do you. We've sorted everything out. Intelligence. We do description, maybe. Can we do column to the right? We can do like Kylo. No, let's just do like a basic description across the board. I think that'll be best. So, intelligence. The agent's ability to comprehend complex information and apply it. And apply it to the real. You know, it's kind of like, yeah, this stuff. Actually, I should say it's book smarts. Book smarts over street smarts. Motorics. The agent's physical reaction speed. Speed. Momentum. And ability to traverse difficult terrain with ease. Physique. The agent's current physical condition. Able raw strength and other healthy let's see, physical condition, raw strength, and bodily integrity. That's all I can really say. Psych, the agent's disposition, charismatic nature, disposition toward others, and ability to work with field operatives or civilian contacts. Resilience, the agent's constitution. Let's see, the agent's constitution and natural immunity to diseases and infectious substances. There you go. We have attribute, then we have description. So here's all our basic attributes, here's all our basic description. Okay, when ranking, so how do we want to word this? The ranks of the attributes indicate an operator's potential and current state in that particular attribute. What this means is that the rank dictates how many the variables while on mission. A higher ranking does not strictly indicate better or worse. That's something simply the potential for the operator to be to express that attribute better, which we then immediately go here, and then we do a mission control briefing attribute ranks. The attribute rank system does not factor directly into die rolls. However, it does indicate a general challenge for certain checks in the field. When determining a challenge for an operator, those with higher ranks may be able to bypass certain challenges or pick up on more nuanced clues. While those with lower ranks may need to make a check to use that ability. For example, it's going to be What did I end up using the one up here? What was the example up here? You, Ymir. For example, Ymir has an A rank in physique, while his squad mate Odin has only a C rank. Odin would when confronted with difficult terrain to navigate quickly, Ymir does not need to roll as they are already strong enough to pull themselves up. Odin will need to make a quick check, however. Alternatively, Ymir has an F rank in psych. While Odin has an A. When negotiating, Odin can get his point across with ease. Difficulty one. While Ymir simply terrifies them. Difficulty three. Again, there's no. I don't want to be like, here's like a strict like set of like direct rules, but it's kind of like indicating like, hey, yeah, you can use these as kind of like a rough indicator of, not necessarily the difficulty, but it's like, hey, you can use these to kind of like give yourself a better understanding. And then when negotiate has a F rank, difficulty. I say it doesn't factor directly into rolls, however, it does. So, all right. Slap an image there. So we've got attributes, then we move directly onto skills. So skills get a little bit odd. Skills. Operators enter the field with a handful of skills and knowledge they have acquired over the years. These skills allow them to express themselves in the world, as well as deal with threats, not immediately with violence. Each skill is tied to an attribute. This dictates how high the skill can be raised. Cool. So if we do this, actually we do attribute grades. Then we do skill rank. Actually, maximum skill rank. We could probably do right. description. So if we do F tier is 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then we do 8 for S rank, kind of like, mind you, these are the number of D12s you're going to be rolling. Can be raised. So like, yeah, having 8 D12s, you can potentially score, let's see, 8 times 3 would be, technically you can roll 24 successes with 8, with a skill rank of 8. I should actually tone that down, maybe. Maybe something like 3, 4, 5, even 6, like, yeah, like, this is already, like, kind of bonkers, because remember, each D12 has a potential of generating 3 successes. And most people are going to have, like, around here. This is where most things are going to be, like, 5. So what I'm going to do is I need to do this. So. Let's see. Complete mastery of a skill. Let's see. Professional use of a skill. Actually, no, we want to do professional use of a skill. Average, we want, so if we do complete mastery of a skill, this would be a step below mastery rating. Actually, no, we want to do untrained use of a skill. Actually, a beginner. Beginner use of a skill. Trained use of a skill. Competent. Hey, now, do you think it's feasible to make a Zelda TR? I've seen they don't shine much in the good department. Kind of depends on which kind of what you're going for with a Zelda game. Because if you say, like, hey, I want to make a Zelda game that is just The Legend of Zelda 1-for-1, then no, I don't think that's really good. If you want to take it more in the vein of Zelda, it could work. It kind of depends on which games you're basing it off of. If you're basing it off of, say, some of the older games, like Link to the Past and things like that, or even like Ocarina of Time, then it gets a little bit more complicated. As those are... Because the basic concept would be, you need to have a dungeon, you need to have different tools, and you need to have pretty much a method to... Not strictly combat, because if you actually really pay attention to a lot of the Zelda games, combat is there, but it's never really like, I want to say the key part. It's not like, the game is not like, it's time for combat. It's like, it's the puzzles, it's the exploration, it's things like that. Combat is a fundamental part, but not like, fuck everything else kind of thing. And... That'd be the hard part. If you want to brace it off of, like, Breath of the Wild, it gets a little bit easier. Yeah, it gets a little bit easier when you get things like Breath of the Wild, simply because you have so much room to work with. But at that point, you're just making an exploration RPG. God, what would be competent use of a skill... I guess if we actually, no, we do skilled use of a skill, professional use of a skill, complete mastery of a skill. Actually, we do educated, skilled, professional. Skilled synonym. adept. There we go. Professional use of a skill, adept use of a skill, adept use of a skill, complete mastery of a skill. There we go. It's kind of along the lines of like, hey, I'm a really trained individual. I probably have like a four in it. So each operator will distribute. Okay, first things first, we need to find out how many skills we're working with. I know exactly what I'm going to reference, because again, I don't want these to be like 5 gorillion skills. That's not the point. That's why we're citing this game. Because there isn't actually that many, is there? Fuck, I need more skills. Game. What game has lots of skills in it? Delta Green. Fuck, what skills do I need? Let's see, with 5, so we do 15 skills, 3 each, or we do 20 skills, 4 each. We do 20 skills, 4 each. Actually, I know what we can do. We can, not tainted bloodlines. This was a relatively recent one, but skill list worked. So let's see. So which ones can we use? Like, so psych, I mean, we can do empathy would be good, wordsmith, and we can probably do obviously something like investigation, technology. Or do we want to be specific with it? Better fit, setting and putting exist like Ritama, even skill use of skill, fun sentence use, most skills I've ever seen, GURPS, also understand playing Yik for research, spend half an hour watching RE2 hunk speedruns and immediately game. Yeah, that's why I actually like doing research for things, because you do get something out of it. Because this kind of game gets a little bit wonky. You know what would be good? World of Darkness. Skills. Tell me more about skills. This is Chronicles of Darkness, right? Yeah, Chronicles. So, physical. Athletics. We want athletics. We want stealth. Survival would be good. Mental, we can academics works, computer works, investigation, medicine is going to be very important. I could probably put that under science, and then put like science, and then put like, it's like probably what I could do is I could add a specialty system that could work. Specialties work. So science, and then you can put it like, or actually no, we put medical as its own thing. Social, empathy is important, persuasion, not necessarily persuasion, not words. What was the good one? Yeah, I think wordsmith was a pretty good one. Because saying you have a way with words. So we managed to get a few skills. Which ones am I looking at? You think your Yik videos are going to get the same as the SUP TSL ones? No. God, no. It's literally just some schizo playing fucking Yik. No one's going to watch a, like, 4-hour long Yik video. What am I looking for? I guess mechanical works. Empathy words. Unless we change the nature of skills. FFG skill. No, FFG. Actually, we should do Dark Heresy. Dark Heresy skills. Larceny. Not intelligence. Interrogation. Because let's think about our, let's think about this right now. Survival, resilience. So survival will be resilience. Actually, because if we go under the idea that we don't really need anything for resilience, because resilience is kind of a special one. Acrobatics, physique, larceny, motorics, academics, intelligence. Computer intelligence. Actually, I can, you know, fuck it. Let's call it just technology intelligence. Investigation. Psych. Science intelligence. Scrap science, we put it under academics. Medical intelligence. Intelligence. Empathy, psych, words, psych, we got 4 psychs. I guess we... we change academics to science. Remove medical. Actually, academics, we do that. We change. Investigation isn't all that important. We change that to something else because it has to be something else regarding that. What is interrogation all about? That is me trying to pluck you for information. That is, give me the word. Words is like your persuasion, is your deception. It's kind of all put in together. It's your way with words. Empathy is trying to understand another person. What does investigation do? Investigation is about finding clues, about finding deductions. So, I guess we put sub out investigation for that, or we say fuck it and just put both in, and then we just do 5 for each. Because I want to have all. I want to have all the things. Okay, so obviously athletics can be physique. That's pretty standard. Motorics can be stealth. Acrobatics, we can sub out for something else. Dark Hunters. Dark Harris. Awareness. No, you're always going to be relatively aware because you're not stupid. Let's see. Agility. Dodge. Operate. Actually, I know that's a good one. Operate. You can do operate, which is the idea of operating a vehicle of some kind. That's all right. That's immediate. Let's see. Sleight of hand, stealth. Well, thanks, talents. Trade, intelligence, strength. Zeke 3353. Intelligence isn't useful for combat, though. That's being the kind of the immediate thing, is that since it's not very useful for combat, it's like having an intelligence means you're kind of already spreading yourself a little bit thin compared to everybody else, which can do a lot of different things. Okay. Not quite equal from what I wanted, but we'll say everyone's going to have a maximum of 5'9". We want an average of, let's say, 3 per skill we choose. Let's say we're going to have access to, let's say, 20 points. Okay, let's just do, each operator will distribute 20 ranks. Let's see, distribute 20 ranks among all of their skills, reflecting previous history. Reflecting previous history and training. Each rank of a skill is another D12. Another action die that will be rolled when using that skill. So possessing a 3, for example, having a three in, we will say, in survival. Having a 3 in survival would have the operator roll 3d12 whenever they are making a survival check. There we go, and then we distribute our skill. Can I put all the skills in one handy little thing? I don't think I can, but I can sure as hell try. We do column to the right, which we do the attribute, skill, attribute, description. So we do athletics, physique. What I can do is me, and I can do these things. Nope, that's not it. Zombie Dark 30. If I'm not paying attention right now, I'm sorry. This is called being focused. Is Yik finished or the last part still pending? Yes. Last part is going to be tomorrow. Because timing got away from me yesterday. So, yep, Yik is going to be tomorrow. Going to be a notepad versus Yik, and it's going to be a fun and exciting adventure. So what we need to do is skill and attribute. So this is going to be the skill, this is going to be the attribute, and this is what we get to do. Athletics. Physique. Survival. Physique. Acrobatics, physique, larceny, motorix, stealth, motorix, operate, motorix, academics, intelligence, technology, intelligence, investigation, intelligence, medical, intelligence, mechanical, intelligence, empathy, psych, words, psych, interrogation, psych. Now let's see if this works properly, which I know it's not going to work, but I can sure as hell pray. There we go. We do that. We have to put everything in the correct one, which is Open Sans. It's Open Sans Undertale, because everybody, that's a funny joke. Please laugh. Let's see. 20. Put them all in their own. Things. Remember when Undertale was like a funny thing and everyone was like, haha, Lamau, it's sans Undertale. I remember those dark days. Because fun fact, I've never actually played Undertale, nor do I have any desire to play Undertale. Because it's not my kind of game. So, academics, the operator's academic ability. Let's see, academic knowledge, knowledge and ability, acrobatics, the operators, grace and what would you describe acrobatics as? Keep balance or avoid jump from heights, move around obstacles without fall. Actually, operator's grace and balance. Athletics, the operator's strength of body and endurance. Empathy, the operator's ability to sense emotional turmoil. Sense the emotions of others. I always find it funny anytime people try to use empaths as like a fucking like superpower, but it's like, oh, the dice rolls in the system. So in this particular system, what happens is, this is the 12v4 system, so what's going to happen is you're going to take a bunch of d12s, you're going to roll them, and you're going to tally up whatever you rolled. So, for example, I rolled a 9, a 12, an 11, and a 1. So, that 1 is bad. It does nothing. It's 0 successes. That 11 is actually worth 2 successes because of 4 and 8. The 9 is also worth 2 successes, 4 and 8. The 12 is actually worth 3 successes, 4, 8, 12. Every interval of 4 is a success. Try to hit over a target number, that's pretty much it. The big thing is, it's very easy to succeed in this game. That's one of the big ideas. It's very easy to succeed, however, it's the idea of more franticness of it all. The goal is to have a very frantic game about, you know, quickly doing something, you know, quickly ripping out a gun and popping a zombie in the head rather than anything else. It's not really about, let's just say, it's not really, how do I want to word this? It's not about the act of doing something. It's when you do it, how you do it, and it, if you fuck up doing it in the last second. In things like, in hunk playthroughs, for example, during hunk runs, it's not necessarily that these guys are missing shots as hunk. That's not the point. The point is, when do they have to actually do the shots? When are they dodging? When are they not dodging? When are they just desperately trying to get the fuck out of dodge? Because you are all competent people. That's one of the big things in this game. You're all competent people who know what they're doing. You're just in a shitty situation. See the operator. Let's see. The operator's ability to force information from others. Investigation. The operator's ability to find and discern clues. Larceny. The operator. The operator's skill. How do we want to word larceny? Larceny is a fun skill. I've used it a few times. Because the entire idea is mostly theft of personal property. However, it's more along the idea of like getting into places you shouldn't. How do I word it in here? Taking logs, burglary, bypassing security. The operator skill at slipping in. Actually, the operator's understanding of locks, doors, and locks and sleight of hand, which doesn't seem very useful. Like, you may be wondering, well, that doesn't seem very useful for badass operator man. But it's also about getting fucking in things, so it's like, hey, I want to pick open the fucking door. Mechanical, the operator's knowledge of mechanics and repair. The operator's skill at medical procedures and diagnoses. Diagnosis. Operate. I should actually change this to Drive 2011. The operators. There we go. Operating vehicles. Stealth. The operators. Remain undetected. Survival. And let's see, the operators. How do I want to operators? Outdoor survival. Conditions, technology, modern technology and tools, words, the operators, persuasive and deceptive nature. So, Finally, each operator may choose two skills. They choose two skills and assign them a specialty. This specialty is a refinement of the skill in question. When it is relevant, the operator is assumed to have momentum. On their check, which means you generate a free success. So we're going to make a sample. We're going to make sample character here real fast, and we're going to make mission control briefing. Agent Ymir. Ymir is a brute of a man from Sweden. Ymir is a brute of a man from Sweden. Working for Working for stars. Actually, Brute of a man from Sweden working for White River. He assigns the following attributes and skills. His intelligence is C. His motorix is B, his physique is A, his psych is F, and his resilience is, ABC is D. Fun fact, Ymir is not going to make it at the end of this. Then we do skill-wise. What skills does he want? He's going to take athletics 2. He's got 20 points. Let's say we have 20 points to spend. So let's say he's going to get athletics. We're going to give him a little bit of drive. We're going to give him interrogation. Can't put a lot of interrogation, but he's going to put some points into it. We're going to give him mechanical. A little bit of medical. A little bit of stealth. Lots of survival. And some technology. So his athletics currently at A, he can put 4 into, so he's at 16. B for motorix, so he's going to put 3 in there, so he's currently at 13. Interrogation is psych, so he can only put 1 point into interrogation. Mechanical is intelligence, and he has a C in intelligence. He's going to be kind of a dude guy in that regard. Stealth, he's going to have a 3 in because he's kind of a commando man. He's going to have a 3 there. He's going to have a 1 in technology. And his big things that he's going to invest his specialties into is he's going to invest his specialties into. Mechanical, because he works on cars. That's what his main thing is cars. And we're going to say is going to be natural stealth. Actually, it'd be natural terrain. Actually, what we can do is survive or cold climate. So let me put this over to the right. Yep. So we do skills, and then we do this, we do attributes. And then we select you, we hit 0 point font, we kind of get an understanding of what this looks like. So mission control BZ. So we know Ymir is not very good with people, but he is actually quite strong, and that means he gets to roll anytime athletics comes up, he's going to be rolling 4d12. Anytime stealth comes up, he's going to be rolling 3d12. However, he's not very good on the intelligence side of things. He doesn't have many intelligence skills, and he also is not very good on the psych thing, so he needs a face to help him out with that. Psych was up to snuff. Again, that psych is pretty much your personality, pretty much your people skills. And sometimes it's useful, sometimes it's not. Like, that kind of depends on the mission. Let's see. So we do this. Like, for example, Hunk has really bad psych. Hunk doesn't deal with people. Hunk has an F in psych. However, he's still a personable person. That's kind of the big idea, is like, because you have a low attribute doesn't mean you're bad with it. It just means you're not good with it. I think like the best way to say it is like, someone with an F in psych is the kind of person, they're not like a bad person. They're not like annoying to get along with, or they're just bad. They just are quiet. They're just not. They can't persuade anybody, let's just say that. Or people just get scared when working with them, and it's just unnerving. They could be the friendliest people in the world, and like, if you're actually friends with them, they're going to be good friends, but they're just terrifying to deal with. That's why it's like, yeah, having a physique of A doesn't necessarily mean you can fucking bench 50, bench 350 and no one gives a shit. Having a really high physique means you're a physically fit person and enough to be able to do stuff like that. For me, for example, I would have a physique of F. I'm not very, like, actually, I would probably have a physique of, like, knowing me, it'd be about C. Like, a Motorix, for example, is an F. Like, I'm not very fast. My knee is a little bit fucked. And for that case, it's like that. His biggest issue is that his resilience is really low for what he does. My back. Ooh. That feels good. Oh, owie, my back. There we go. Okay, there we go. So, something feels wrong about this. I can't put my finger on what it is, though. Something feels very wrong with it. It's exactly what it needs to be, however. Okay, so next we have to do combat capabilities. So, combat capability. Capability. An operator's job is simple. Actually, operator is called into a mission because there is expected hostile resistance. An operator squad is called into a mission because there is expected hostile resistance. Combat is a necessary part of the operator's skill set and abilities in the field. Being able to stomach and perform admirably on the field is an essential quality of being a part of the war on terror. being a part of this dangerous profession. Yep. Now let's go up here. Alpha Protocol? God, I don't even think you can buy Alpha Protocol anywhere anymore. Unless I get it like on some fucking Steam key on a site. See, I'm gonna see. Okay, this is gonna be a test. I have to move my mic slightly. Let me just try something real fast. I need to literally see, look at my my input capture. There's one. No, I can't do it. My old mic used to be able to pick it up. Anytime I roll my shoulders, I hear cracking noises. It's... There we go. Yeah, this mic doesn't actually pick them up at all. Like, it's right in my shoulders, actually. Fun fact. Is what happens is that I move my shoulders up and move them back, and it's just this cracking noise. I've actually asked doctors what it is, and the only thing they can really tell me is, to quote, the fuck? Yeah, you know those, like, Dr. Scholl's things they sometimes have in stores when you have to, like, walk up and you lay, like, oh, well, let's measure what your back looks like and stuff like that? I took one once. there's, like, little red bars. The thing is, like, there's these little red bars that usually show up for, like, oh, your body is this or whatever. Mine went off the page. They don't know what happened. I've been to, like, physical therapists before. And, like, it takes them, like, a while to, like, just do the knots in my back. And, like, I had one lady be like, dude, I can't do this. I'm like, don't worry, you're not the first. Like, it's, if I would need to get, like, a very, very well-trained individual to, like, do that. You know, like, one guy, he would have to do my neck every time. And, like, when you hear, like, your neck, like, snap into place, it's a weird sensation. It's like, huh. Huh, this is weird. So, I stopped going to him because he was like, hey, you know the politics. I'm like, yeah, boss, I do. He's like, let me tell you why I like Tulsi Gabbard. I'm like, Nani the fuck? Like, I, oh no. Like, Mr. Man, please just fix my back. Okay. Those are 1-3. So, being able to stomach and perform admirable in the field is an essential quality of being part of this dangerous profession. Actually, I want to do a double check. Yeah, okay, so this is about the same. Because he doesn't have that many skills in other places, so he needs to be, someone needs to make it up for him. Okay. Okay. Use skills and specialties, but refinement of skill in question is refinement of the skill. Refinement of the skill in a. How do I want to do that? How do I want to do this? Okay. This is where things get a little bit weird. Because of this. We go. Being part of this dangerous profession. An operator has a combat capability rating of three. Whenever they are in the combat scenario, they will roll 3d12. They will roll three action die to perform their actions. Okay. Capability, whether they're CCR 3 in combat scenario, they will roll 3 action die to perform their action. Action related to combat scenarios. Okay. Combat capability, because the idea behind combat capability is pretty simple, is, yeah, you have a combat capability of 3, that's your, the CCR represents a combination of combat training and skill. Standard soldiers and trained fighters only have a CCR of 2, while militia and civilians may have a CCR of 1. More dangerous entities and trained soldiers may even have higher CCR rating. More dangerous entities and trained soldiers may even have higher CCR. Higher in the midst of combat. Then we do 3, which we're going to call the surge value. During a combat scenario. The operators will need to make a surge check, which is their CCR rating. Actually, no. What am I doing? I don't need to talk about that yet. What kind of zombies beyond the basic ones? The idea, like, I'm gonna probably put in like the most. Your standard special kinds of infected, Like, you're a big zombie, scary zombie, impossible to kill mutant animal dog zombie thing. Kind of like your standard Resident Evil ones. Then I'm going to go probably a little bit more into the Left 4 Dead side of things, mostly Left 4 Dead 2. And then go into some of the weirder Resident Evil stuff. It's kind of that's what I'm kind of basing it off of. It's like, yes, here's a zombie that runs dead, has a fucking dead sprint at you and tries to pick you up and beat you to death. Or, hey, here's a zombie over here that, like, you get shot, like, who has a gun and is trying to shoot you. Or, hey, here is, you know, the zombie, I can't believe it's not the smoker. Things like that. Generally, I'm going to borrow a little bit from pigs and how I plan on doing it. Make Wesker as the gold standard. Yeah, Wesker is going to be part of the super, like, kind of the idea of super soldiers. Which the idea of being like, this is a heavily mutated individual who can control their mutations, and they are very terrifying. For example, during like, I would say Resident Evil 5, Chris has a CCR of 6, Wesker has a CCR of 7. Both of these individuals are horrifying to behold. Like, Chris is like the gold standard of like a monster human being. Boulder punching and all. Like, he is a super highly trained soldier at that point, if only because he's not only a STARS member, but he's also a plethora of other things. While, what's the Boulder CCR? Objects like that don't have CCR, luckily. Because the idea behind, like, the idea is, just think of, the big thing is, you're going to be very easy to hit. It's one of the big things I want with this system. Is this is tactical action. Clearance Clearwater Revival. Hey, yeah, I might call it the CC rating or something like that. But CCR works. Because the entire idea behind it is, let's say, there's two people standing in a room together and they're looking at each other. Whoever draws the gun first is probably going to be the one to hit you. You know, that was the opening song, actually. They're the ones who are going to pull out the gun and they're going to shoot you. However, what do you do to make yourself easier, harder to hit? You start moving around. You start diving for cover. It's the tactical action aspect is going to come into the idea of you have a maximum of 9 successes on your dice. And if you're in heavy cover and like they cannot see you and a bunch of things, it's going to be really hard to hit someone. However, here's a secret, everybody. That's when you start flanking. That's when you start, throwing shit at people. And that's when it's like, yeah, okay, here's a problem. Here's a grenade. And it's like, oh no, I'm going to get shot by a grenade. Yeah, it's like, that's going to be kind of like one of the big ideas behind how the operators function is I want you to feel like you are supposed to be this heavily aggressive individual compared to everybody else. You can generate 9 successes with an average of 3. While they, on the other hand, have a CCR of 2. Pretty much in standard soldier and, basic trained fighters are going to have a CCR of 2. Most civilians and like militia guys are actually going to have like 1. They can only roll like 1 or 3 successes. Where they're not going to hit you if you are literally in heavy cover. They're probably not going to hit you because they don't know what the fuck they're doing. They're just shooting blindly at you. These guys don't know what they're doing. That's where you start. And honestly, an operator should be able to, take care of a handful of, civilians. That's what it's like, one of the goals would be, arguably, to recreate the opening of RE4. Of, you are Leon Kennedy, man with CCR 4, CCR 3 at that point, probably. Veteran Superman, effectively. And these guys aren't trained, they're not soldiers. You can pop them pretty easily. That's the entire idea. It's, oh no, there's an enemy. Bang. Because the thing is, that opening section isn't scary because Leon is this unkillable Superman, it's scary because you are running out of ammo constantly. Like, you don't have that much ammo. You are getting surrounded. It's the frantic nature of the fact that you can take these guys out pretty quickly, but you're just outnumbered. There's more of them than you, and you're rapidly approaching, you know, that. And then a fucker with a chainsaw appears who can take a few more shots and isn't going down. It doesn't matter how cool and skilled you are, a fucking chainsaw gets you, you're kind of DEA dead. So, CCR1, most dangerous elite, and... most dangerous entities and mercenaries may even have higher CCR in the midst of combat. Let's see. So we understand what a combat capability is. We know we mark down our CCR is. Yeah. Mark that down right away. Felt like there should have been more there. Combat capability wasn't very big. Vitals system. Okay, so that means we're going to have to talk about our vitals now. Vitals. No, no one is more. No one is immortal yet. During combat, the operators may take bashes, bruises, and other problems. These are referred to as wounds. Each of the limbs, right arm, left arm, right leg, left leg, torso, gut, head, and head have a different number of wounds depending on the operator's resilience rating. Actually, no. The different number of wounds that can be sustained. And then we do. Wounds. So we need to do our arms, legs, torso, gut, head. Let's see, arms can have a maximum of 4 wounds, legs can have a maximum of 6 wounds, let's say 5 wounds. Torso, like, your torso is like your upper torso, so you can get about, let's say 5, you can get about, let's say 6 wounds there, your gut can have about 6 wounds, and your head can only have 3 wounds. We bump you up, so 5, 6, 6, actually, we can probably do something like this. So 5, 6, 8, 6, 3. Let's see, during combat, wounds to be sustained. When an operator takes a wound, they will take a, what do they end up calling it? Yeah, they will take a hindrance. They'll take a hindrance whenever that particular limb comes up. all torso, let's say torso, gut, and head wounds apply to every, like to every roll, apply to every check. That comes up in a, whenever that comes up in a check, wounds apply to every check. And apply to every check. Pretty much, if you get like shot like 2-3 times in your torso, you're fucked. Like, you are not doing too good. Like, you can take a few hits, but your things aren't going too hot for you. You're taking hindrances. Ballistics. This was CCR of like people like Lady Dimitrescu. It's kind of hard because she doesn't actually like engage in that heart of combat, but like dealing how she's a horrifying mutant mold woman, she would most likely have a CCR like 6-7. The entire idea being like she is this individual who in a straight combat scenario is gonna fuck your day up. However, you have two advantages over Lady Dimitrescu. One of which being, she doesn't have a gun. You know, when in doubt, open up fire on that woman. I'm always reminded very simply of Vampire the Masquerade Bloodlines when you're talking with Jack. One of the very first lines you get with Jack is, yeah, we're immortal vampires, and... what was that? We're immortal vampires, but a shotgun will put you down pretty fast. It was like, and it kind of put in the context of being like, yeah, no, it's like, yeah, you're super cool and all that, but like, doesn't matter what occurs. If you shoot it enough, it will die. Or to quote Arnold Schwarzenegger, if it bleeds, we can kill it. What clan was Jack? I believe he was Bruja. I want to say he was Bruja. Can't remember. He's Bruja, right? Okay. Come on, I believe. Yeah, he's Bruja. Okay. He's 10th gen. Oh, geez. Oh, he's 9. Yeah. Let's see. Head wounds apply to every. Apply to every, actually. But actually, when an operator takes a wound, they will take a hindrance. They will take a hindrance to future checks. So we want to do torso. Torso, gut, and head wounds will apply to every check. When an operator reaches 0 wounds in a, let's say you reach 0 wound in a limb location, it is considered to be ruined and unusable until major medical attention is received. An operator reaches 0 wounds in a limb is received. However, what we can do, we do limbs. How do I want to word this? No, we need to do limb. Need to do column right. Effects of ruin. Arm, leg, torso, gut, head, arm. Operator cannot use any equipment. Cannot use any equipment with that limb. Operator cannot. Operator moves at half speed. Actually, operator's movement is crippled. They can only move at half speed and require assistance. They require assistance to move. Torso, death. Gut, death. Head. Delayed death, agonizing death. Actually, I should say is agonizing death, slow death, instant death. Yep. Okay, so let's see. Combat capability rating. No one is immortal. Then we do our final one, which we call the initial specialization. Initial specialization. Operator. During their training. Soldiers are often given specialization when they reach a certain point in expertise. Operators are heavily trained and have undergone some of these specializations. During their initial recruitment, each operator may select their first specialization, which. Granting them a perk which reflects their personal abilities and situation. So generally speaking, the first initial ones we're going to have vanguards, which are kind of heavy offense. We're going to have defenders. We're going to have guardians, which is heavy defense. We're going to have field operator. We're going to have field specialist. Actually, we're going to have field tech, which is more skill monkey. And we're going to have our final one, which is going to be, which would be a good one? Heavy offense, heavy defense, skill monkeys, and, Um, Give me some ideas. Beltway, explosive weapons. Carina Le Pleu. Christine Yamada, she is operator and virologist. The Delta team. Vector. Field scientist. Beltway. Spectre is surveillance. Smooth operator. Does this game work for not being part of some special team of some corpo a la Umbrella, but still being badass with skill protecting a settlement? At that point, you're going to be part of STARS. Pretty much the UN guys. Like, you're perpetually underfunded, but never... yeah, welcome to being the defender of the free world. Actually, we can probably give them, like, a reconnaissance... recon, which we're going to give them a very certain look. We're going to do that. We're going to extend that down, which is going to be a Vanguard. You can either select to be a Vanguard, Guardian, Recon, or our initial one, which is going to be Field Tech. We like field techs. Field tech. Reflect the personal abilities. As the operators complete missions, they will be able to adopt further perks. Perks down their initial tree. Among general perks. General perks, or delve into different specializations. Pretty much what I want to do here is like, how do I want to do the trees? Is like, the trees build off certain aspects. That's kind of the idea. Like, there's going to be a list of like, here's some general perks that you can always take. But if you go down, like, specifically the Vanguard tree, you're going to be a heavily offensive person, and this is, you get an advantage of these situations. If you select to be the Guardian, you get these benefits. Recon, these benefits. Field Tech, these benefits. For Guardian, for example, which is, toughen up the crack. Breakable, which is. Actually, the Guardian gains momentum. How do I want to do this? When in doubt, review what we have. Actually, okay. Guardian. The Guardian increases their torso and gut wounds by +1. So they can just take a little bit more damage than everybody else just by virtue of being the Guardian. Let's see. So combat guys who are super combat aggro, who go super, super aggressive. I might wait on these ones. I'm gonna wait on these ones. I'm gonna keep this here. I want this to be here, but I need to get the combat section done before any of this makes sense. Because where we are right now is here, so we're doing pretty all right. Field tech, yeah, kind of the idea behind the field tech is you can go down more like, you're the guy whose, like, special job is to be, like, we're dealing with, you know, virus stuff, we're dealing with more, like, you just have more stuff. You're able to take more things with you. Just kind of like, on deployment, you can take more shit with you by virtue of being the guy that the bosses trust to carry everything. And that's why it's like, yeah, this is actually pretty useful, but is it like super duper useful for everyone to do that? Not really. It's like, yeah, but it's like, I also want to get more HP. Or, hey, I want to do, or you can go down more along the lines of like, these guys are skill monkey tech operators. They're the ones who get a lot of specializations. They benefit very heavily from doing things in the field rather than strictly in combat. That's kind of the ups and downs with them. Again, it's everything's up here. Everything's up in my noggin, and it's just going to be how I can do that. Because I don't usually deal with like specializations and stuff. Those aren't usually my thing. But I think I'm going to call it there for today. I need to think on this a little bit more. I might literally go back to this later tonight and just rewrite chunks of it. Have you made yourself a Mass Effect RPG yet and know of a good one version of it? Kind of depends on your specific flavor of poison, what you're looking for. I made this a long time ago in a galaxy far, far away, which was standard issue science fiction. I believe that this is the reason. Yeah, this is standard issue science fiction. As you can tell, this was even before I like started using title cards for everything. This is actually one of my bigger games from back in the day. You can run Mass Effect in this. I believe I actually stat out Krogan. Do I stat out Krogan? I think I wanted to stat Krogan out. I think that was like the idea, is like I wanted to stat like different races out, but I never did. Yeah, but like if you want to do that, you do. The armor of the future is energy shields. That's how it works in that regard. where was it? If you really want to make that worse, you probably have to do milestone into the what I was just saying. Ah, there's stuff. Most likely, you'd also want to do the war story, or if you're feeling really, really spicy about it, the Two-Fisted Galactic Throwdown. That's kind of the idea behind it. Making a dedicated Mass Effect game, because there's a few Mass Effect games out there that people have attempted over the years. And kind of depends on if I feel like it or not. That's kind of the idea. Like, I like Mass Effect, but man, do I like Mass Effect that much? That's kind of a different question entirely. All right. I'm gonna call it there. Godspeed, good luck. Appears everyone's fighting in my server again. God help us all. So thank you all. I will see you all on, well, tomorrow. I'm gonna see you all tomorrow, in which we finish Yik, end of Yik Vangelion. I'm ready. Hopefully you are. God help us all.